Good morning, everybody. It's Eva from Bohemian Crafting here again. It's end of March, nearly end of March, and most of countries in the world are locked down because of coronavirus. And it's time to send some message to our families, to our loved ones, which we can see now. And you don't need too many things to make something amazing. You can send a message via Messenger or via email, or Facebook or Skype, you know, all those things. But more exciting and enjoyable is sending something what receiver can open and fold and pull out. And you don't need too many fancy things to do something like that. We've got here those newspapers and we will create something. So I'm gonna tear one page and we will make a base. Then you will need just super simple printer paper where we will write some message. Open some newspapers and good images you like. Maybe you will like some notes, some sayings, maybe crisscross things. Maybe there will be some flowers. Good images you like. I do have a few of my images, and maybe somewhere in your newspapers are some forms for filling up something where you can write down addresses, maybe some, you know, subscription. Cut it out as well. We will need that for our address spot. So cut it out. Well, I found few beautiful images like flag, some signs, that form, those queasy things, and also kitchen, and I think few flowers was there, yeah, few flowers. So I'm gonna move it, and we will create our base, and then we will start to be creative a little bit more. Take your white paper and try to fold those long sides together. It doesn't have to be exactly, but if you will be lucky enough, you can fold it nice way, those two sides together, like this. And now those opposite sides together, somehow like this. And here I guess you can leave small gap to make that base more in envelope size, so you don't have to put those two exactly together. It's good to leave there some small gap. Probably like this. Take your newspaper, fold one side nearly to the middle, place this on the top, and try to fold that other side the way that it will be over the edge. It will cover just the edge of your base paper. And now glue those basics. Take a glue. Oh, come on, fold yourself properly. Straight. Take a glue and glue those two pieces. Like this. Take your base paper and glue that base paper here on the bottom of your newspapers. Like this. Fold it. And fold this over. And you have prepared the base for your envelope. Now, if you found in your newspapers some form you can fill up, take that form take back your newspapers and try to find some darker color. I think I'm gonna use this red one. Yes, I'm gonna use this red color. So I'm gonna glue this back to this piece of newspapers. And I'm gonna cut frame around my label. I think about 1/4 inch, a little bit more maybe. Like this. I've been cutting because it wasn't straight. So I've got a teeny, teeny small one. And I'm gonna cut those corners a little bit. And last one. Oh, come on, Evie. Just cut that corner. I'm gonna take marker. And I will go with my marker very carefully all over the edge of this label. It will make like a beautiful frame around your label. If you will etch that edge. And it gives you time to relax with crafting, with creating something beautiful for your loved ones. So with my marker, I'm going all over the edge of this label. Very carefully, because it's easy to slide down with your marker. And to draw some unexpected drawings. Unexpected lines where you probably don't want them. So this way. Yeah, like here. Now, take your back envelope. And here, I would like to create a kind of background like my envelope. So I'm gonna measure this one. It's 6 1/4 by 4 1/4, 4 3/8. I'm gonna cut from white paper a smaller frame and I will glue it down. So, like this, I did cut paper 5 7/8 by 4 1/8. And I did glue it down and now I can place here my label and it will go straight away. But before I will do it, I'm gonna take marker, this one, and I will doodling all around of this paper. I'm gonna make doodling lines, just like stitching, to make it more decorative. You can write some small notes here on that stitching all over of that top of your envelope. Like this, and now I can glue it here on the top, my label. Like this, and because I found this bear in my newspapers, I'm gonna glue him right on this spot. Like this. We will open, oh, maybe here. Yeah, later. Later, we will open our envelope and we will start to decorate our letter. The inside will be space for some note. You can write a letter on all over this paper, but I would like to create something all around as well. I'm gonna use this second bear and I'm gonna glue that paper right here. Cutie bear right here. Spread it, make sure that but it's not too much of glue, but it's everywhere. I'm gonna glue this, not his, him, right here. And I'm gonna make decorative edge of this letter. I'm gonna take my ruler and draw a line. I think in the middle of that bear. Here and here. And with my scissors, it just fell down. With my scissors, I'm gonna cut that white paper around the bear. Like this. And from here. Like this. Like this, so from that other side, it looks like he belongs there, from the start. On the opposite side, I would like to put those quees thingy, those beautiful quees pieces to some envelope. They are similar, which is great for me, so I'm gonna take my newspaper back, I'm gonna choose some page, and we will create pocket for them. So I do have here some offcut from newspapers. I clipped those quees together to make sure they will hold together. And I'm gonna kind of wrap them to that newspaper page to make sure that my pocket will be big enough. Like this, take them off, and I think I would like to have some flap of my pocket, so I'm gonna cut it right here. And somewhere in the middle of the pocket, so I'm gonna use this column like my measurement, like that straight line. Yeah, good. Okay, I'm gonna place these inside again, and I'm gonna fold the bottom. And fold the top like this. Open it. And now I'm gonna cut here. Where is that fold? Cut it off. And here to small angle. Opposite side will be same. Here small angle. And here where is that fold? Cut it off. And that top one we will do, where is the fold cut? And where is the fold cut? And same on the other side. Where is the fold cut? Here I'm gonna place a glue and make that top a little bit more stronger. With a glue, I'm gonna glue it over it. Like this. And now fold this one. Put glue here. Fold this one over. Put glue here on this edge. and a little bit of the on the bottom, and put glue here on this edge. Oi. And on the bottom. Hopefully you've got better glue than I do, so it will go a little bit better way. You just created pocket for your pack from newspapers. And you can play with this if you want so. You can take that marker. Here we can cut corners, make it a little bit decorative, like proper envelopes. Take a marker. If you have distress inks, if you are a crafter and you do have distress inks, take distress inks. You can distress all those edges if you like vintage look. And with that marker, go on all over all those edges. It will make huge difference. It will make it more decorative. And you can do also those doodling things. You can draw pictures on it. Like this. And here as well. Like this. Take your letter, open it, and we will put our teeny mini envelope, probably right here, I think. If you have at home some string, it doesn't have to be something heavy more. I will probably say something very light, which will be good for, you know, if you want to send that letter somewhere. It's always better to have something not heavy. Take that string and just make a knot. Bow. Not. To make possible to open it later. Just bow. Of course, make it more decorative than I did it now. Take a time. Do not rush. Like this. And I guess. Yes, this way. So to make sure that it will hold properly. Try to glue it nicely, put the glue there, and I think I will place it right here. Do not glue it over the fold. You will have a problem to close your letter later. Now take your pencil and try to do doodling lines everywhere you want. So I'm gonna go with my pencil all over all those edges, and I will do like frames, that doodling, stitching, drawing. It's very relaxing. You can draw flowers, you can write some messages even in this drawing. Once you have done all this drawing, we will continue for putting things on that letter. I did my doodling on all those small pieces, all over of those pages. And now here I do have kitchen inspiration. I did cut it from those papers, so I think I'm gonna glue it right here. And I'm gonna fold it. And fold it. I think this way. To make small package. I think I saw in those newspapers white piece of white paper. Well, I haven't. I found only that blue one, so I'm not gonna stress out about white paper. I'm gonna use my offcuts. This is the piece I would like to glue it here, and this will be on the top. So here I will place a glue because it will be on the top. I will put the glue here. And I think I would like to have on the top some printing, some writing. I'm gonna glue it on the top, and now I'm gonna cut all around like this. Here I can cut a little bit more. I'm gonna take this one. Cut corners again because I like that shape. It looks decorative. I will use marker and I will go with that marker all over those edges. So I did that drawing all over, and I did my stitching on this piece, and now I'm gonna put it together. I'm gonna glue this on the top, and we will do string wrapping again to make it beautiful and fun. I'm gonna glue it here. I'm gonna take a string. Place it from the bottom and glue it on the top to my teeny meeny small space. Wrap this and make decorative bow, if that only possible. And that rest space you can decorate with another pocket, with some goodies. You can place there another pictures and make it more interesting. So once you have decorated everything you wanted, just write your note. You can put there a few more embellishments. You can draw a few more pictures. Close it. Put the glue here on this strip, glue it down, write an address and send it. And you've got envelope made from newspapers, and everything inside is pretty much from newspapers, except that white paper. I hope you did enjoy it. I hope you will try to create something from newspapers. It's so much fun. Enjoy your craft, stay relaxed, and see you next time. Bye!